even if you do not know much about contemporary Christian music, and you've been worshiping here for a while, you have sung Wayne Watson music. Our choir loves singing Wayne Watson music. We've had several soloists do that, and so you have been blessed by his music, even if you were not aware of it. And so we're thrilled to have him with us. And it is very rare that we have an opportunity to get personal with someone like Wayne. So I asked him if he would give us about 3 or 4 minutes and let me ask him some questions and have him respond to give us a better feel for how God has blessed his life. So first of all, Wayne, tell us about how you came to know Christ.
I grew up in church. I shared last night with people. I grew up in church and gave my heart to the Lord when I was a little boy, 9 years old. And never knew much past that, knew any other kind of life. I don't have a very exciting testimony, and for that I'm extremely grateful.
And how did you know that God wanted you in the music ministry? What kind of things took place in your life to lead you in that direction?
Well, I'm still not sure. I'm still waiting to find out what I'm going to do when I grow up. But I remember coming down the aisle of our little church where I grew up, and, you know, I don't know if they do that anymore, rededicating my life. I don't even think rededicating is a word, but that's what we used to say, rededicating my life. And I just looked at the preacher and I said, I think God wants to do something with me special. And I never had a mystical call. I never felt this Emmaus Road sort of Road to Damascus kind of thing. I never felt that. But I did feel like God opened some doors, and the only way to know his will is to go through the doors he puts in front of you. If you're waiting for some grand scheme to unfold, a lot of times you end up waiting your whole life without realizing anything. And he opened a few doors, and I went through them, and they led to other doors, and they led to other doors. And this is not what I wanted to do with my life. I never had ambitions to do this. I wanted to be a ball player. I went to college and I thought I could be a ball player, and I saw other real ball players and I decided not to. And I saw one good fastball and thought, music, huh? All right. And the Lord really confirmed that. But that's why I think after 22 years now, I still enjoy it, because it's not something that I live and breathe for. I don't like so much what I do. I don't love what I do, but I love what it does. I enjoy what I do, but I love what it does more than I love it itself. So I like seeing eternity stirred by the just what goes on here every Sunday. God's word being proclaimed, music speaking.
And you have an opportunity to travel all across the country. What are some needs that you see in the body of Christ as you travel around the country? That'll be my last question, and then you can see.
Well, growing up in church, I feel like I have not the right. I'm cautious to use the word rights, because I know what we deserve. We don't deserve anything. We deserve to die and spend eternity separated from God. So when I say rights, but growing up in church, I feel one of the greatest needs we have as a church, not as this church or my church, but as a church, is to walk away from some of our pride. I think that's what's brought us to some of the things we're facing right now. We've become somewhat vain, that we understand God and we understand what he's going to do. And by the way, he's not so mysterious after all. I'm here to tell you he is, and we don't get it all. We don't understand everything God's up to, and it's our obligation to fall at his feet and just trust that he will carry us where he wants, and that he will do as he wants to do, and we should follow him. After the things happened earlier, back in September, I saw a lot of people praying, and someone asked me, how do you feel about seeing so many people praying on television now? You see them bowed in prayer on the newsreels, and my first response was, well, I just hope they're praying for the right things. I hope we're praying the right prayers. I hope we're not just praying, God, make it safe for me to go to the mall again, to get back to my safe life. But I hope we're praying, God, what are we doing wrong? What are we holding on to that we shouldn't hold on to? What could we do to be more pleasing in your sight? And that was my prayer, and continues to be my my prayer as we evaluate where we are as people, not only a church, but just as people. So thanks for letting me be in your church home this morning. Many Sunday mornings we're on airplanes, and this is a lot better.